today's press conference to present the preliminary statement of findings and conclusions from the Election Observation Mission from the OSCE Office for Democratic Institutions and Human Rights for yesterday's second round of mayoral elections. Presenting the statement this afternoon will be Ambassador Audrey Glover, the head of the OSCE Mission here. We will have time for questions from the media after Audrey presents our findings. So without any further ado, please.
Thank you, Tom. Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon, and a very warm welcome to this press conference. It's good to have you with us. We're holding this press conference today in the knowledge that Boumero and AA have not accepted the results of the election. As I said at the last press conference, we would follow post-15 October election developments and have a presence for the second round, and we have. We relocated our LTOs to municipalities where the race for mayor continued. We also had 88 short-term zones, 75% of whom were with us for the first round. So we're satisfied that we had sufficient coverage for the election yesterday. Our conclusion from the last round was that the election on the 15th of October contributed to strengthening confidence in the democratic process. But despite shortcomings, the legal framework provided a good basis for the conduct of democratic elections. Although gaps, ambiguities, and an inability to make consistent decisions within the law remain, voters' trust in the electoral process has decidedly increased. So how does that assessment measure up against the latest round? The legal framework continues to provide a sound basis for the conduct of democratic elections, although the SEC did not plan adequately for the second round. Most provisions of the Electoral Code are applicable for the second round. However, the Electoral Code does not clearly regulate certain aspects of the process, reducing coherence of the electoral framework. So how about the parties and campaigning? Campaigning took place against the backdrop of calm relief due to the increased confidence of voters resulting from a relatively uneventful first round. We have noticed that during the campaign there was much more reaching out to voters across ethnic lines. Electoral contestants were able to campaign freely, and the freedoms of association, assembly, and therefore less centrally driven. There are only a few large-scale rallies, and they are organized mainly by SDSM. The Prime Minister attended some. He promised local development and EU and NATO integration. Some parties were concerned that the Prime Minister pledged government support for those municipalities who elected a DUI or SDSM mayor, because this undermined the separation of the state and party, which is contrary to OSCE commitments. The ceiling for campaign expenditures was the same as for the first round. Two interim reports were required by contestants before the first round, but there were no sanctions if they did not submit them on time. Third round reports were due on the 28th of October, and only five contestants complied. All were published on the SEC website. So what about the role of the SEC? Although it has improved its transparency between the rounds by more consistently announcing sessions in advance and posting some decisions online, it continued to make some decisions behind closed doors. Neither did it sufficiently prepare for the second round. For example, additional training for MECs was too little and too late, and it gave hardly any information even voters above the second round will give timely financial support to 10 municipalities with blocked accounts. It identified where additional training is needed, but it didn't implement it nationwide. Positively, six MECs on their own initiative organized additional training for the election boards. The work of the MECs was generally assessed to be positive. However, at least one case of perceived political bias was noted in the run-up to the second election. Over 40 complaints were made to the SEC on the first round and were decided in an open session with discussions put on the website. All, however, were rejected, and discussions at times were antagonistic between some of the SEC members. The manner in which complaints were handled challenged the rule of law and due process in contravention of OSCE commitments. Voter lists were not updated during the two rounds of voting. This prevented those who became 18 during that period from being able to vote. In addition, more than 900 voters in penal institutions were unable to vote because they lacked identification. Furthermore, the SEC adopted a decision by which voters who were on voter lists but whose identification documents expired between the two rounds were not allowed to vote in the second round. Previously, persons in that situation had been able to do so. The SEC, however, did urge voters to renew their IDs, but this caused some confusion. In relation to media, news coverage of the campaign was limited, but increased in the final week. In private media, the paid advertising was dominated by the two larger parties and was mostly negative in tone. The public broadcaster provided contestants with free of charge airtime during prime time, and five candidates used this opportunity. Media monitoring of the second round indicated that the public broadcaster covered all contestants in a balanced way and in a neutral tone. A high number of paid advertising spots, negative in tone, were largely used by Bureau and at times by SPSM. So how does all this add up? The 29th of October, second round of mayoral elections was competitive, and the respect for fundamental freedoms contributed towards the conduct of democratic elections. The campaign was short and subdued, with parties vying for support beyond their traditional base, though occasionally using aggressive rhetoric. Isolated cases of misuse of administrative resources and vote buying were reported. Media continued providing balanced coverage of contestants, but this was overshadowed by negative campaign spots. Election day overall was professionally managed, although the performance of polling staff during counting could have been improved. Tabulation was assessed as efficient and transparent. At the last press conference, we said that those elections saw the country's democratic progress advance, and the confidence and trust of the voter in the electoral process increased. We think that these elections contributed further to strengthening confidence in the electoral process and the democratic progress of this country. We will be providing our second and final report within 2 months after the completion of this electoral process. Thank you.
Thank you, Marjane. As I mentioned, we now have time for questions from media. If you do have a question, I would ask you please to just raise your hand. We'll have a microphone brought to you. And before you ask your question, please just give us your name and the media outlet that you represent.
Доброго дня. Какого вы оцениваете navedeno pre premijeru Zoran Zaev i podrška za što tu im podade na nekoliko kandidati u Duri, bideki tua, evo, тоа не е според принципот на употреба на власна партијата.
I'm sorry, forgive us.
This is a little problem with the transition there for a moment. Oh, we've got it. Okay.
I'm sorry.
Apparently there was a difficulty with turning on your channel. I could ask you, could you please just repeat the question?
Како ја оценувате поддршката на премиерот Заев, што ја подаде на кандидатите за Аргентина? Бидејќи тоа, како што спомнате, но спотребно принцип и потреба на државата од партијата.
Support of itself doesn't separate state and party. It was only that the Prime Minister said that in those areas where a DUI candidate or SDMS candidate had managed to win the electoral race, that he would ensure that in those instances that money would be given to the municipalities. So the fact that SDMSM and DUI are in coalition is not problematic at all. It's what the Prime Minister said.
Further questions?
Горан Трбенци, дигитална редакција, сакам да кажам. Вчера лидерот на ОБР да помане, упати големо обвинување на целиот изборен процес и не ги признава изборни резултати. Дали имате некој коментар за неговите обвинување? И дека полицијата многу била вклучена во изборен процес.
Well, of course, we have heard what the leader of the party said. We have heard, of course, what the leader of the party said. And I think that our reaction is that if the party considers that there's been any violence, then, of course, that violence and those complaints should be pursued with the appropriate authorities, the police. In addition to, if they consider that there have been any contraventions of the electoral code, then they should use the electoral system, which is, of course, applying initially to the SPC. But what I would say is that in relation to the allegations that were made, as far as we're concerned and can see, they were allegations, because neither our long-term observers, nor our short-term observers, nor any of us who had actually gone out and observed the electoral process yesterday saw any violence at all. So if there are allegations of violence, as I say, as far as we're concerned at the moment, they would appear to be allegations. We did and have seen, however, that in relation to vote buying, photographing ballot papers, and one or two other such family voting, we did see that take place, which of course the police are looking into. But in relation to the violence that has been alleged, we haven't as yet seen any evidence of that. Neither do we know whether the violence took place before the first round or in between the first and the second round. And as you may know very well, we don't deal in allegations, we deal in facts.
Борисов Стојковиќ, Информис. медиуми да објавуваја снимки и фотографии во насилствата на и меѓу изборите и за време на изборите. Оцеката на ОСЕ за е насилства и за прекомерната полицијска присутност на избирачите.
Well, we have seen some of those photographs. We found them out for ourselves. They were never shown to us. But I have to say that from looking at this photograph, it's not at all clear exactly what is happening. But I'll repeat what I said before, that if there is any concern that there has been violence, then it is up to the party concerned to refer the issues to the police for them to look into. We are here as observers. We're not election police. We cannot interfere or intervene in any way in any electoral issues.
Any further questions?
Дали може би имате средба с учесниците на изборите, кои тварят, односно кои не ги признаа локалните избори? Дали може би имате средба со представниците на ОДИХР, за да ви објаснат за наводите кои ще ги изнесе во јавност?
We are obviously always prepared to meet anyone who would like to meet and talk with us, as long as they understand what our role is and we are of service and cannot intervene in any way.
All right. So with that, once again, thank you for joining us here this afternoon for this press conference. On your way out on the table near the exit, you will be able to find copies of the preliminary statement we're presenting here today in English, Albanian, and Macedonian, as well as the press release for this conference in English and Macedonian.